jewels gone?
Gone.
It must have been the Franciscan father who shared my bed last night.
At your age, madam?
To some young men, my charms have far from waned. Oh, well, since the blame is attached to me, it is my responsibility to repair our fortune.
Oh, pardon me, madam, but how do you propose
think,
to do...
young man, and think. Buenos tardes, señores. It is your privilege to encounter the greatest courtesan of Paris, France. All one needs to enjoy her immortal favors is a princely sum. Gentlemen, gentlemen. Oh. I was not born in Sanic Hispania. My mother came from Rome, no Gobernia. But now I'm here, I'm dancing a tango. Die, 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 die. I am easily assimilated. Ooh! I am so easily assimilated. Oh. I never learned a human language. My mother spoke a high Polish. In one half hour, I'm talking in Spanish. Por favor, hurry up, door. I am easily assimilated. Oh, I am so easily assimilated. It is ever so easy. I'm Spanish, I'm talking in Spanish.
Oh, yeah.
marooned on a desert island. While Mademoiselle Cunegonde is undergoing heaven alone knows what indignities at the hands of the terrible Turks of Constantinople.
On Mademoiselle Cunegonde and her indignities, what about ours?
Yes, what about us? Swindled out of our rubies in England.
Sent off to drown in a leaky skiff.
Our complexions ruined by the sun.
Our fingernails split.
Tormented by sand fleas.
Doomed to an eternal diet of crustacea.
And algae.
And an occasional sea slug. I vain that the daughter of the high archimandrite of all the Russias and that paragon of loveliness, the Princess Vanda von Rovno-Vobenia, should have come to this. No doubt you'll think I'm giving in to petulant emotion. But in candor, I am forced to say that I'm sick of seaside living in the middle of the ocean. And I wish that I could leave today.
Madam, I'll take a mollusk if you please.
But they're all gone.
Liar! I saw you sneak a whole pile of them underneath your skirt.
I have suffered a lot, and I'm certainly not unaware that this life has its black side. I have starved in a ditch, I've been burnt for a bitch, and I'm missing the half of my backside. I've been beaten and bit and repeatedly stripped. I've been forced into all kinds of whoredom, but I'm finding of late that the very best fit is to perish of sunburn and whoredom.
Patience, ladies, patience. Have we not, by the grace of some higher power, survived even worse calamities?
Like what? That's what I'd like to know. Like what?
Eldorado is not an enlivening spot, but we left it with rubies and treasure. And it seemed guaranteed I was going to lead a career of indulgence and pleasure. But what happened? Here's a sea slug.
Just out with the sea slug. I want a mollusk. It's mine. One of us mine. You've been asking for this for days.
No, ladies, please.
You keep out of this. You see? You deceitful old Polish slut.
Slut. Slut. Who are you to speak of sluts? You brazen vest. Alien whore!
Oh, ladies, please! I realize it is difficult at times to preserve the niceties of civilized behavior under the weight of such sorry circumstances. But at all costs, we must remain serene and considerate of each other's feelings. And above all, never, never lose our self-control.
Slut pork.
You're a vile old tart with a hard, hard heart, and you steal all my muscles and scallops.
You consume like a pig all the clams that I dig. You're the birds, the Vespalian trollops.
How disgusting that you,
after all we've been through,
should be greedy and grasping and selfish.
Must I starve on this shore with that quarrelsome core? Oh,
How could my lips have framed such a discourtesy? Pardon me, ladies.